Hello, my fellow VR users. Today, I'm going to show you how to mod Beat Saber using SideQuest, but doing all of it with a phone. That's right, a phone. So instead of using a computer or a laptop, for those of you who don't have those, you can use an Android phone. It unfortunately does not work with iPhone, so all the iPhone users out there can't do it. But if you have an Android phone, you're in luck. Let's get into it. Modding Beat Saber can seem a little overwhelming at first, especially right now with mods not being updated to the newest version of Beat Saber, so we have to go through the entire downgrading process before we can even mod Beat Saber, but don't worry, I'm gonna show you step by step exactly how to get Beat Saber modded on your Quest. Okay, so to mod Beat Saber using a phone, you're gonna need a couple things. First, you're gonna need the Android phone. Second, you're going to need your Quest, and you're going to need a cable. One that will plug your Quest into your phone. So get whatever cable you need, whether it be Type-C or micro USB or whatever it is your phone uses, get the cable you need to be able to plug them into each other. The next thing I need you to do is download SideQuest on your phone. So go to the Play Store app, type in SideQuest, find the app, and get that downloaded. Okay, I'm gonna need you to download one more app from the Play Store. It's called Bugjigger. This app is going to allow you to take the downgraded version of Beat Saber, the APK, and put it onto your headset so that way we can be on the right version for modding. I put a link in the description for both the apps, Bugjigger and SideQuest, for easy access. So to get Bugjigger working the way we need it to, we need to enable developer mode on our Android phone. So I'm using a Galaxy Note 8, but any Android phone should just about look the same when you're in the settings. So you should have no trouble finding the developer mode access. So we're going to navigate to settings and then find About Phone, Software Information, and then when you see Build Number, we need to tap it 7 times repeatedly. So we're gonna just go ahead and hit that 7 times. Developer mode has been turned on. Excellent. Now we go back to settings and developer options shows up for me now at the bottom. So we need to go into developer options and find debugging, USB debugging. Perfect. I'm going to allow that so that way when we plug in our headset, we'll now have access. We also need to activate developer mode on our Oculus account to get SideQuest working properly. So I put a link in the description below that'll take you right to developer.oculus.com. You will need to create an organization name. So choose whatever name you like. I just go with my handle. And then you'll want to read all of the terms and conditions, make sure you understand what you're agreeing to, and then click submit. Go ahead and stay logged in to the Oculus website because we're going to need to come back to that here in a little bit. To finish enabling developer mode, head over to your Oculus app on your mobile device, select devices at the bottom, and scroll down to developer mode and make sure that it is enabled. Okay, now that our apps are squared away for now, let's do a little bit of headset prep. I'm going to put my headset on and uninstall Beat Saber. For those of you who may be watching this video in the future, to know if you need to downgrade Beat Saber or if you can run BMBF without downgrading, you can go to questmodding.com. I put a link in the description and you can scroll through under news and it'll tell you which version of Beat Saber mods are updated for. All right, so we know we need to downgrade to version 1.17.1 of Beat Saber to be able to get working mods on our Quest. So I put a link in the description to computerelite.github, and that's gonna be where we can grab the downgraded version of Beat Saber, which is the APK file. Earlier in the video, I told you to stay logged in to your Oculus account. If you're still logged in, great, just leave it in another tab so that way the Computer Elite website can see that you're logged in, because they need to know that you have paid for Beat Saber before they'll let you download an older version. If you're not still logged in, go ahead and log in really quick and then go to this website. So once all that's taken care of, you'll go to headset and search term and type in Quest and Beat Saber, and then you can hit search. After it loads, you need to select Beat Saber, and then we are going to scroll down all the way to 1.17.1. which is this guy, and we're gonna download it. Now that your APK file is done downloading, plug your headset back into your phone and launch the Bugjigger app. You need to make sure that your headset is still powered on. I had my phone plugged in when I launched the app and nothing prompted me, so I unplugged it and replugged it back in, and then I got the pop-up for Bugjagger, and I went ahead and allowed that and then opened it with Bugjagger. I did, after allowing it on my phone, I had to go back into my headset and allow it in my headset as well. Then I was able to allow Bugjagger to access the Quest 2 again. It's a little confusing. I'm just gonna choose Bugjagger again for the USB device. Okay, so after unplugging the cable from my phone a couple of times and going back and forth between clicking allow on my phone and allow in the headset, I finally was able to get Bugjagger to connect and show connected to a device at the top here with this. I don't know why it's called Hollywood, but that's the name. Okay, once you're finally showing connected on the Bugjagger app, you can click over to packages, which is the little square with the arrow in it. So then you're gonna click the plus symbol up in the top of the screen, and on select APK file, we're gonna hit okay. So then I'm gonna go to downloads because that's where mine went, and I see here Beat Saber APK. Okay, it took a second, but now the install seems to be rolling. So we're just gonna give this a few minutes. Okay, so we saw it said package installed on the phone. Now to confirm that we're on the right version of Beat Saber, I'm gonna put the headset on and Beat Saber should be installed and on the correct version, which we were aiming for 1.17.1. So it's gonna show update available, which is because we are on a downgraded version of Beat Saber. So when you hit launch, you're not gonna hit update now, because if you do that, then you'll have to reload the APK file again. So hit update later. And we did it, it was a success. We're now on Beat Saber version 1.17.1. Okay, we are almost there. You guys are actually doing great. That was the hardest part. I've never downgraded or modded with the phone. I've always done it with the computer. So learning the Bugjagger app and trying to like do it all on my phone has definitely been a little bit more difficult, but it's gonna be so worth it because modded Beat Saber is so much fun. Okay, now we need to open up SideQuest so that we can download BMBF and get mods on our Quest. I noticed that my connections were kind of messing up between Bugjagger and the SideQuest app. So the best way that worked for me was launching the SideQuest app and then plugging in my headset. And then I allowed all the permissions on my phone first and then went into my headset and allowed the permissions there. Before, I kept having to go back and forth allowing from my phone and my headset. So in case you come up with that same issue, that was the process that worked for me. Once you're showing connected in SideQuest, you should see the little green light at the bottom in the middle. Type in BMBF and then you're going to hit download app. You'll see that it says it's installing. Wait for the install to finish. Time to put on our headset. Okay, so in our headset, we're gonna go to apps, and then in the top right corner under all, we'll go all the way down to unknown sources and launch BMBF. If BMBM doesn't launch and stays white, close out of it and relaunch it again. I had to do that, and then I am now able to allow BMBF access. And now we're met with the setup introduction. So read along so you know what you're doing, but you're gonna follow along clicking on all the pink buttons until the process is complete. I would like to note that the patching Beat Saber did take a while, so be patient with it. You might get a pop-up saying you don't have permission, so just go and allow and then hit back. My install did freeze about 70% done, but you just have to wait for it to complete. You will probably get a pop-up saying package installer isn't responding, so just hit wait. Don't hit close app, because then you'll have to start over. After BMBF completed everything, it did freeze up on me. It wouldn't let me click on anything, so I went ahead and closed it down and relaunched it. It's gonna ask you to restore the app, but don't restore, hit close. After that, I was able to click on browser and view all of my mods. So now here we are. I'm gonna click on Get Mods. And then here's all the mods that are available for the version of Beat Saber 1.17.1. My favorite actually is right at the top, Trick Saber. So I'm gonna go ahead and download this. And then once it's queued, you can hit Sync to Beat Saber. Success. So you can continue going down the list of mods and reading the descriptions of all the ones that you like. Chroma is another good one. But there's a lot of other mods, so definitely scroll through these and download all the ones you want. Don't forget to sync when you're done. And then to get all your songs, you can use Beat Saber here and download any of the ones on the front page, which are all going to be good. Like Map of the Week is always awesome. So you're going to want to download that one. Awesome. Added. Let's go. If you wanted to search one, you can click the search tab up here and then type in whatever you like. Rez is one of my favorite artists, so let's go ahead and grab one of her maps. Well, her songs, somebody else mapped it, of course. This one, amazing, download. And then anytime it asks you to restore or update the app, don't do it. You can hit open app in this scenario, and then if it asks you to update the app, just hit update later. And now we have Beat Saber modded. We can finally play some of the custom songs that we downloaded. And we have our mods here, which I only downloaded a couple, but you can go through and decide to download all the different mods that you would like to download. We did it, you guys. We downgraded and modded Beat Saber with a phone. I hope that you guys can get some really awesome songs and cool mods and have a bunch of fun with Beat Saber now. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking and subscribing to the channel. Turn on all notifications so you don't miss more videos like this in the future. Let me know in the comments below, too, if the video was helpful or if you have any questions. And of course, if this video wasn't helpful to you and you feel like leaving a downvote, please let me know why. I want to know what went wrong in the video and how I can make it better in the future. Thank you so much for watching.